then you'll be mine.
Was not to her liking.
That is nothing. I'll attend her here and woo her with some spirit when she comes. Say that she rail, well, I'll tell her plain. She sings as sweetly as a nightingale. If she do bid me pack, I'll give her thanks as though she bid me stay by her a week. If
she... I bid thee pack for thine that special face. Ha!
Gracias, senorina.
And now, Petruchio, speak.
Speak, Petruchio. But thy message was not meant for me.
Good morrow, Kate. We're on stage now, lady. Good morrow, Kate. Well, that's your name, I hear.
Well, have you heard, but somewhat hard of hearing. They call me Catherine that do talk of me.
You lie in faith, for you're called plain Kate and bonny Kate, and sometimes Kate the cursed. But Kate, the prettiest Kate in Christendom. And therefore, Kate, take this of me, Kate, of my consolation. Hearing thy mildness praised in every town, thy virtue spoke of and beauty sounded, though not so deeply as to thee belongs, myself am moved to woo thee for my wife.
Moved in good time. Let him that moved you hither remove you hence. I knew you at the first, you were immovable.
Oh! Why, what's immovable?
That you were not stool.
Thou hast hit it. Come, sit on me.
Asses are made to bear, and so are you.
Women are made to bear, and so are you.
No such gin as bear you with me, you mean.
Come, you wasp. In faith, you are too angry.
If I be too waspish, best be bear my sting.
My remedy is then to pluck it out.
I have the book of find where it lies.
Who knows not where a wasp is, where it sting, but it is tail. I'll cut you if you strike again. You keep on behaving just the way you've been doing, Miss Vanessa. I'll give you the penalty of life right here on stage.
You wouldn't dare.
No?
If you strike me, you are no gentleman. What is your crest? A coxcomb?
A coneless cock, so Kate shall be my hand. Come, give me thy hands.
No.
I said, come.
No.
Now, setting all this chaff aside, thus in plain terms, your father has consented that you shall be my wife. Ah! And will you? Kneel you, I will marry you. Now, Kate, I am a husband for your church. So by this light, whereby I see thy beauty, thou must be married to no man but me. For I am he and born to tame you, Kate, and bring you from a wild Kate to a Kate conformable as other household Kate.